The dressing is intact. The edges aren't lifting. It's perfectly sealed. But there's blood on the edges of the gel pad, and it's leaking out to the edges of the dressing. And I think that's an indication that this dressing needs to be changed.
I agree. What else you got?
The date strip is in the wrong spot, and also there's no date on the date strip.
Also a problem. I'll go and see if I can find his nurse.
Oh, hey. And who are you?
Oh, hi. I'm Liam. I'm with infection prevention. I'm a new infection preventionist. I'm just here doing my rounds.
Oh, hi. Welcome.
So I just want to give you a heads up about something. I think Mr. Hoffman needs his CVC dressing changed. If you want to take a look here, there is blood leakage, and whoever changed the dressing last time didn't document the date correctly.
I thought it looked fine. You know, I got a lot of patients I haven't gotten to yet. I wish I could focus all my attention on just one patient, but I have the whole floor to look after.
Totally hear you. And it's not an emergency, but it really should be changed as soon as feasible. Do you think you might be able to get to it when you get the chance?
Rebecca, there you are. I was just looking for you. I see you met Liam, our new IP. He just moved here from Mercy General. Super knowledgeable.
Two nurses called in sick today. We're so busy.
I'm really sorry to hear that. Is there anything I can do to help?
No, thank you. I'll take care of that line in a bit.
Cool, thank you.
So, how do you think that went?
Tough crowd. You know, I feel bad adding tasks when I know how stretched the frontline often is.
Yeah, but what you're asking for is important to protect patients. And ultimately, it could be more work for them if the patient develops a complication and requires additional drugs and therapies, not to mention harmful to the patient. From what I could tell, it sounded like you were handling it really well.
Thanks. I appreciate that. You know, I've rounded on CVCs before, but I'm curious if you have any specific protocols or tips. I want to make sure I'm remembering to check everything.
Yeah, what we really focus on here is standardization of our practices. We emphasize early detection and preventive measures and want to be sure that our feedback to the front line is consistent from unit to unit. I'll explain more as we go.
Okay.
Got your checklist?
Yes, I have it here. It's the one from the CDC website. Is that okay?
Yeah, that's the one that we're currently using.
Okay, cool.
Ready for the next line?
Let's do it.
Tell me a little bit more about your process.
Well, to start, I use the checklist. I go over every point made on it, and then if there's something specific, then I'll note that as well.
Great. I love that you have this checklist and that you're using it in real time to guide you so that nothing's overlooked.
Yeah, I think it's been super helpful. Okay, so the first step is inspect the dressing.
When it comes to inspecting the dressing and the insertion site, I look for three main criteria: dressing damage, blood, and site visibility. First, is the dressing damaged or not?
No. In this case, it looks totally intact.
Next, is there blood outside the gel pad?
No. There is a little on the pad itself, but that's normal and okay.
I agree. And lastly, is the insertion site fully visible? Has the gel pad absorbed a lot of liquid that has obscured it?
No. The pad looks good. Okay, so we inspected the dressing. Next, we checked to see that the dressing is labeled with the date and time. Which it is. It looks like it was changed 4 days ago, so 3 days to go.
Great. So the dressing looks good.
Mm-hmm.
What's next?
Next is the catheter. Is it secured to reduce movement and tension? And it is.
Yep.
Okay, cool. Next, we check the entire infusion system. So we would inspect for alcohol impregnated caps, check the lines, and then we check to see if the administration tubing sets are labeled with the start date and time, which they are, and is it within the specified date and time range for use?
Let's find that out. Yep, great.
Yeah, cool.
I just see one red flag.
Yes, me too. And that's the lumen there needs an alcohol impregnated cap.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so last check on our list, are all inactive ports capped according to facility policy? And the answer is no.
Leaving tubes uncapped is an open invitation to central line associated bloodstream infections in our setting. So what's our verdict?
That the dressing looks good, but that lumen needs a cap. So I'll just go grab one.
Oh, wait. That's actually the care team's job. They should be made aware, and then they should take their own corrective action. Your job is to monitor, not to nurse. Doesn't mean you can't help out when necessary.
Okay. All right, well, that's the whole checklist, so I think we're all good.
Great.
Cool.
Let's go. Okay, so what's next?
We could check some more patients' rooms. Let me just see
who's
next.
Here you are. Do you have a minute?
Oh, hey.
Hey, Rebecca, sure.
So I changed the dressing you asked about earlier. A few things I don't understand. What are the indications for the immediate dressing change? Is there a website or?
I actually do have something that I think could help you, particularly because I know you have some precepting responsibilities for new nurses. It's a great resource for education. You might find it useful too, Liam.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. Sounds good.
As they say, a picture is worth 1,000 words. So here are some examples of central line dressings that definitely need to be changed. If you remember the basic principles, it'll be easy to quickly identify the issue.
So here we see blood is leaking outside the gel pad, touching the white band. It's the same issue we had with the dressing we asked you to change.
Yes, blood outside the gel pad feeds bacteria. We see here that the gel pad is not covering the insertion site. It's covering the hub. That's wrong. The purpose of the gel pad is to protect the insertion site. In this photo, we see that a wrong type of dressing is used and the date of the dressing change is missing.
It's crucial to document the date to avoid any complications. Here we see that the catheter is bent.
Bent catheters can restrict the flow of medication or infusions. Also, the CHG sponge pad was applied upside down. It's not protecting the insertion site. This dressing has no CHG gel pad, and this patient was not CHG intolerant. In fact, there is no CHG protection at all, like a round CHG sponge. This can lead to rapid germ growth.
Wow, thank you. That makes sense, and that's a great resource. Would you mind sharing a copy?
Sure, we're always happy to help.
Sometimes there are so many things to keep track of that you need a reminder.
Yeah, no worries. It's our job.
Thanks.
Yeah, I've handled plenty of CVCs before, and sometimes you see something that really stands out.
What are you seeing here?
Well, the line here, it's not covered by the dressing. The dressing is not intact, and there's excess line between the securement and the insertion site. Now, that portion of the line's been exposed, and I'm concerned about the position of the line and that the excess redundancy will be pushed back in.
Yeah, for sure. So how would you address that?
Hey, Julie.
Yeah.
Can I show you something real quick?
Sure, what's up?
So we have a little bit of an issue here. The line appears to have migrated out a few centimeters. I don't know if it was pulled, but it's something that we need to take care of ASAP.
Okay. Yeah, I see. But the fluid is getting through just fine and the insertion site is covered. I just changed this dressing yesterday and we don't want to disturb it too often. Can it wait until the next time I change the dressing?
So I totally hear you. And I do agree that the line is functioning, but the dressing is not intact. Securement appears to be compromised. So at this point, it's a safety issue that should be fixed as soon as possible. Is there anything that I can do to help you take care of it?
Did you hear that, Mr. Lewis? I'm gonna have to change your dressing again. Sorry.
Again? But you just changed it. I think it's fine.
I'm really sorry, Mr. Lewis, but it's like I told Julie, we do have to also be worried about infection. So, I really hate to say it, but what we have here is an open door for germs.
Oh, come on. Really?
Yes, really. We wouldn't be asking if it wasn't important. So let us get this better secured, and it can save you developing problems related to the line. Thank you. So it only looks pulled out a few centimeters, and it should not change the position of the tip in the central blood vessel. But you could still give the physician a heads up just for awareness.
Okay, will do. And I'll replace the securement to fix the line in place. I will not push the exposed segment back in, and I'll give the team a heads up.
Awesome, thank you very much.
Sure.
Thanks, Mr. Lewis.
Well, very productive rounds.
Yeah, it gets tricky sometimes though.
True, every healthcare worker faces their daily challenges, and caring for patients is demanding, but you're doing great, Liam.
Thanks, I appreciate that.
You know, I feel like we're always taught that it's essential to understand the facts, but I feel like it's also equally as important to learn to communicate that knowledge so everybody understands the importance too.
Yeah, communication is a big part of the job.
Yeah, the nurse got it right away once I explained the problem to her.
And that's why they have us, the IPs, because they have so many other responsibilities to manage. And part of our job is to care for the entire team, making sure that they're valued and that they're getting the help that they need.
Mm-hmm.
Coffee?
Yeah, absolutely. It's on you, right?
Of course.